What are complex numbers? Are they as complex as they sound to be? We come across complex numbers while studying various concepts in high school and college. Complex numbers are used while describing the motion of the spring, pendulum in classic physics, while studying the wave equation of quantum mechanics, and engineering fields like signal processing. Big games like GTA 5 and Max Payne that you can download via internet can only be compressed by algorithms which extensively use complex numbers and their properties. Even the image processing and image recognition techniques used by Snapchat and Facebook are possible only by using complex valued functions. So let us try and explore these new set of numbers, which you will see are not that complex after all. But before learning about complex numbers, let us quickly jump into the history of the number system which we are familiar with. There has always been a need to quantify things that we humans come across in our daily lives. With the invention of numbers 1 to 9 by the Arabs and 0 by great Indian mathematician and astronomer Aryabhatta, it became possible to represent these quantities. These numbers can be placed in an ascending order on a line or a ray starting from 0. That is, in an increasing fashion from left to right. Also, two or more numbers can be arithmetically operated to get a new number. This is what we know as the positive number line. With the advent of basic algebra dated back in 800 AD, mathematical interpretations got even simpler and use of alphabets became more common to represent variables and to determine the solution of various equations. Like we know, solution for equation x minus 5 equals 0 is 5, or solution for x plus 4 equals 5 is 1. But in the positive number line, there is no solution for equations such as x plus 2 equals 1 or x plus 5 equals 2. To solve this problem, English mathematician named John Wallis extended the number line to introduce the concept of directional numbers. He described the numbers that are placed to left of 0 as negative numbers. Also, it is important to note that negative numbers were placed in the opposite direction as that of the positive numbers because they give a negative effect on the number line. That means each of the numbers to the right of 0 is multiplied by factor 1 and the numbers to the left are multiplied by the factor minus 1. This can also be seen in a different perspective. Taking number 0 as the origin, the negative number line makes an angle of 180 degrees with the positive number line. That is, it is said to have a phase shift of 180 degrees with the positive line. Also, it is found that when two numbers are multiplied or divided, their phase shifts are added or subtracted respectively. Like for example, when a 180 degree phase shifted number, say minus 2, is multiplied with 0 degree phase shifted number, say 3, we get minus 6, which has a phase shift of 180 degrees. Also, when minus 2 is multiplied by minus 3, we get 6, whose phase shift is 360 degrees or simply 0 degree. Further, with the invention of decimal number system, we found that there also exist numbers between two numbers. This combination of positive numbers, negative numbers, and 0, including the decimal numbers, is what we know as real numbers. And the line representing these numbers is known as real number line. Yet there were equations that had no solutions even on this number line, like this equation x squared plus 1 equals 0 or x squared equals minus 1. We know that this equation has no solution on the real number line because we know square of any real number is always positive. So what's happening here? For the solution of the above equation to exist, we need a number that generates a phase shift of 180 degrees when it is multiplied twice with itself. Such a number can only exist if its own phase shift is either 90 degrees or minus 90 degrees. Hence, to solve the problems like the above equation, a new set of numbers of phase shift of 90 degrees or minus 90 degrees were needed to be introduced in the number system. In 1806, in Paris, John Robert Argand first published the idea of this addition in the number line system. The upper half of this axis represented numbers with phase shift of 90 degrees and each number multiplied by a factor of under root minus 1, and the lower half represented numbers with a phase shift of minus 90 degrees, and each of those numbers were multiplied by a factor of minus under root minus 1. The factor under root of minus 1 was denoted by the ninth letter of Greek alphabet, that is iota. This axis was named as the imaginary axis, and the horizontal axis was named as real axis. The plane defined by these two axes is called Argand's plane. Therefore, the solution of the equation x squared plus 1 equals 0 is this. Hence, every number can be thought of as two-dimensional vectors with a horizontal displacement known as real part and a vertical displacement known as imaginary part. If a number is purely real number, then its imaginary part is 0 and it lies on the real axis. While if a number is a purely imaginary number, its real part is 0 and it lies on the imaginary axis. These numbers were called sophisticated numbers, which we now know as complex numbers. For more information on complex numbers, stay tuned for the part 2 of this video. And if you like this video, please subscribe to our channel, and thanks for watching.